Okay, my cornerstone chums, it's time again for Banking Basics. This is Mr. Matt coming to you from Classroom 6 here at the lovely Cornerstone School. That's why I'm wearing my mask. Alrighty. So, just like last month, your benefit automatic deposit notice is here. Okay. So, from SSI, you get 750 big ones. All right. And it was paid to you on December 1st. Okay, from Social Security's benefits. Okay, so is this, excuse me, if you're going to the bank from the government, the bank, government's computer, told your bank's computer to put this money into your bank account. So is it a withdrawal, taking money out, or is it a deposit, putting money in? If you said deposit, you are correct.
Deposit.
All right. Okay, when was this check deposited? Remember, it says right up here, 12/1/2020, which stands for December 1st, 2020. Okay, so let's see if we can zoom in here. Okay, December, we got 10/14/2020, which is October. We've got November 1st, 2020, which is November. I'm sorry. We've got 1/1/2020, which is January 1st, and we've got 12/1/2020, which is the same as up here. So let's choose 12/1/2020. Alrighty. How much was the check for? Right here. It was for 750 big ones. $50, $750. I gotta zoom in again. What fun. Gotta love it. It is $750. And who sent this check? It's not letting me click on it. Whoops. Whoops. Come on, just let me get in there, will you? Ah. Ah. Guys, the best I can here. Who sent this check? Was it Kris Kringle? Was it Sally Seasons? Was it Social S Services Benefit? Ah, indeed, Social Services Benefit. All right. Now we need to mark this date on the calendar and write the deposit in our check register, so hang in there. Okay, so here we are on our calendar page, and the deposit was made on December 1st. So, oops, let's try to zoom in again. What did we make on December 1st? Was it, hold on, is it paying the rent? Did we pay the rent in the first? Was the rent due on the first? We make an ATM withdrawal on December 1st? Was the phone bill due on December 1st? Ah, we got our benefits deposit check on December 1st, right? All right, let's go to our check register. Okay, here we are in our handy dandy check register form. Okay, so As of December 1st, our beginning balance, or how much we had in the bank as of December 1st, was $2,318.90. So also on December 1st, we deposited our SSI check. So, oops. And it's not a withdrawal that's taking money out. It was a deposit that's putting money in. Okay. So we're going to type in 750 dollars. So we use a calculator, which I have right here. Okay. 2,318 dollars and 90 cents plus, gotta use the plus sign right here, $750. Whoops. Okay. Equals. After you add the two numbers, you hit the equal sign and you get, see that, 3,068.90. 3,000. It's so funny how they have me bouncing the check before they give me the ding. It's okay. All right. Okay, let's go back to the next activity. Okay, before the next act, before the next part, we have to check off that we marked the date, which we did, and we wrote the deposit in our check register. Okay. All righty, next up on the list is to take cash out of our bank account. We're going to withdraw. We're going to be taking money out. Here's the receipt that you get when you go to the ATM. And you use your ATM card, which you keep in your wallet, and it looks like this, something like this. Okay. Alrighty. So at the N2Y Bank on 550 Elm Street, okay, you took out on 12/2/2020, which is December 2nd, 2020. You took out $100. Holy moly, 100 smackers. Okay. And like we said, it was a withdrawal. You took out money out of your checking account. So, right. When was the money taken out? You just said December 1st, right? Let's see if we can zoom in here. Getting better at the zoom in, zoom out thing, huh? Goodness. Okay, when was the money taken out? It wasn't April 16th. It wasn't December 25th, Christmas Day. It was December 2nd, 2020. All right. All right. How much money is being taken out? $100. All right. Okay, now we're going to have to mark this date on our calendar and write this withdrawal in the check register. Here we go. Okay, so here we are on the calendar again, December 2020. And there's the benefits check deposit. Now we have to, on Wednesday, we have to zoom out. So we'll zoom in. On Wednesday, we have to not pay the cable, right? Not pay the rent, but we did make an ATM withdrawal, okay? Oops. So that's what we did on December 2nd. An ATM withdrawal, okay? How about that? Okay, here we are on the check register. And let's see, December 2nd, we made an ATM withdrawal. How much did we take out? It's not a deposit. Nope, not the plus sign, not deposit, a withdrawal, takeaway. Just the takeaway sign on your calculator. Takeaway minus. Okay. We withdrew $100. All right, so now we have to use the calculator again. We still have our amount from before on there. I can't see it, but there it is. $3,068.90. So now we do takeaway or minus $100 equals, hit the equal sign, you know, two lines. Oh, little mistake there. Let's try it again. $2,098. I'm sorry, $2,968.90. All right, let's type that in. Right, so now we have $2,968.90 in our bank account after taking out $100. All right. Okay, next we go online to look at our utility bill. Okay, so let's see, we've got a bill here from Central Utilities. And it's funny, they're charging us for water and electric. All right, but not gas. Okay, so let's see. The water is $58.22. The electric is $82.43, which comes to a total of $140.65. A lot of dinero, a lot of moolah. And you have to submit your payment to centralutilities.com. Pay it online. What type of transaction is this? Okay, if you're going to be taking money out of your checking account, giving it to the utility company. Bye-bye money, flies away. Okay, so that's going to be a withdrawal. Okay. Righty. When is the payment due? Okay, it's due by December 10th, 2020. Okay, so let's see. I'll type that in there. Whoops. One of these says December 10th, 2020. Let's try this one just for kicks. Oh, wrong one. Let's take that out of there. Let's try it again. December 10th, 2020. December 10th, 2020. All right. Okay. And how much do we owe? $140. And 65 cents. Oh, baby. All right. Oh, I put five. $140.65. I need a new set of glasses. Okay, who do you make your payment to? Central Utilities, right? Central Utilities. All right. Let's see which one says Central Utilities. All right. This one says Orson Millet. This one says the Farmer's Bear. This one says Central Utilities. All right, there you go. All right. Now we have to mark the due date on the calendar. We have to mark the date to make the payment on the calendar. Hint. Count 5 days before the due date. So 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. So we're going to pay it on the 5th, even though it's past the 5th today. But this is make believe. All right. So we're going to pay it on the 5th, December 5th. And we're going to write the payment information into the check register. Okay. Okay. Here we are at our handy dandy calendar again. All right, so December 1st, December 2nd, December 3rd, December 4th, December 5th. So, what did we do on Saturday, December 5th? Oops. What fun the way it zooms out. Ah, gotta love it. Right. Was the rent due? Did we pay rent? Did we pay the phone? Did we, would the utilities due? Actually, no, we're paying the utilities before they're due. So, right. Okay, now. The utilities are due on December 10th, right? Right. On December 10th, okay, the utilities are due. So, as per instructions, we're paying it on here. We're paying it 5 days before they're due. So, one, the due date, one, two, three, four, five. Okay. Alrighty, now to add it, or subtract it rather. Okay, so here we are. And December 5th, we paid utilities. Oops. And we paid it wrong. $140.65. Okay, so we need to subtract $140.65 from $2,968.90. Okay, so $2,968.90. I know this is like some numbers are swimming through our head here, aren't they? Take away the minus sign, take away $140.65 equals $2,828.25. All right. Okay, so stay tuned for the next part of this activity. Hello, my Cornerstone peoples, and this is the second part of Banking Basics, or rather, continuation. Okay, so time to record your debit card payments. Okay, you had to make a payment on your debit card. Or rather, let's see, you made a payment with your debit card. Of course, again, a debit card looks like this. Take it out of your wallet. There it is. Magnetic strip on the back that you put into the slot. Okay. And you spent some money at a place called House of Holiday. Let's see. House of Holiday. And it was on December 7th, 2020. You bought stockings, wrapping paper, spools of ribbon, boxes of ornaments, artificial tree. Whoa. So you spent 147 for Christmas stuff. Wow. Okay. So what type of transaction is this? Okay, you're taking money out of your checking account. Okay, and you're giving it to the House of Holiday. Okay, so it is, if you're taking it out, it's a withdrawal.
Withdrawal.
Okay. When was the payment made? Okay, get ready to zoom out. Here you can see the payment was made on December 7th. So let's see what our choices are. Okay, well you've got December 7th, June 28th, November 9th. So if you said December 7th, you're correct. Okay, so the payment you spent $147.04. Oops. Okay, who was the payment made to? House of Holiday. Let's see what our choices are. Was the payment made to? Was it Silver Bells? House of Holiday? Buddy Farrell? House of Holiday is correct. All right, now we need to mark this payment on the calendar, and we need to write this payment in the check register. Let's do that. All righty, here we are on our calendar page. And we're talking about December 7th, right? Okay, let's see what our options are. Oops. Did we pay the rent? Was the rent due? Would pay the phone bill? House of Holiday payment? You said this, you are correct. And it won't let us do it. How wonderful. All righty then. Go to the check register. Okay, here we are at our handy dandy check register. So on 12/7, oops. 7, we made a payment to, was it, House of Holidays? Was House of Holiday. It's holiday. And how much was it for? Let's see. Okay, it was for a whopping $147.04. So we need to subtract that from our balance, which is $2,828.25. And that leaves us with a balance of $2,681.21. All right, let's go to our next transaction. Okay, the next item is congratulations. You got your first paycheck for the month from N2Y Bank Direct Deposit, December 11th, 2020. Okay, that's today. All right. A check for $93.48 has been deposited into your account from JB Services. Isn't that nifty? Okay, so if it's going into your account, it's going in. If you're putting it into your account, is that a withdrawal or a deposit? Okay, if it's going into your account, into your bank account, it's a deposit. Plus sign, okay. When was this check deposited? Okay, let's see what our choices are. All right, see up here, deposit alert. One second, 12/11/2020, December 11, 2020. Here we have 6/19/2020, 11/24/2020, 12/11/2020, right? 12/11/20 equals two. Okay. Correctivo. How much was the check? $93.48. Who sent the check? See up here, it was sent by JB Services. Okay, to be where you work. Down here, we have the choice of JB Services. JB Services, Harry Hanukkah, Smithstone Store. All we know is JB Services.
JB Services.
All right. Now we have to mark this date in the calendar and write this deposit in the check register. Okay, here we are at our calendar again. And on the 11th, what did we do? What happened on the 11th, December, whoops. December 11th, what happened? Did we pay the cable? Paycheck? Phone due, pay gracious giver's donation. He thinks it was a paycheck, correct? Alrighty, there we go. Look, put that on our calendar of important events. Now we'll log into the check register. Okay, let's see here. 12/11. Paycheck. And it's going into the deposits because, you know, it's going into our account plus, oops. $93.48. Now we're going to add $93.48 to $2,681.21. Which gives us a grand total of $2,774.69. Yeah, baby. All right. Okay, our next item of business is to pay the rent. All right. What type of transaction is this? Taking money out of your account to give to your landlord. All right. So it's a withdrawal. Minus sign. Okay, when is the payment due? Actually, let's go back. Rent is due by December 20th, 9 days from now. Alrighty. December 20th, 12/20. Choices are October 10th. Is that the same as December 20th? Nope. April 20th. Is that the same as December 20th? Nope. December 20th. Is that the same as December 20th? Yep. And how much do we owe? A very reasonable $585 in $585. Okay, very reasonable. All right. Who do you write the check to? Hampton Apartments. Okay. So we're writing the check to Snowy Shop, Elfin Market, Hampton Apartments. Yes, you're right, Hampton Apartments. Okay, so now we got to mark this the due date on the calendar. Mark the date to make the payment on the calendar, which is 5 days before the due date. So we're supposed to pay the rent 5 days in advance. Write the check and enter the payment in the check register. Okay, lots to do, lots to do. Okay, here we are back on our calendar to record important events. Okay, the rent is due on December 20th. So let's see here. Oops. Sorry. On December 20th, someone says rent due. Yes, you're right, right here. All right, so we want to pay it 5 days in advance. So if we count back 5 days, we go one. Get this out. One, two, three, four, five. The 15th. On the 15th, we are going to pay the cable, pay the phone, pay the rent, pay the rent. Okay. Okay, we're back at our oh so important check register. So on 12/15, we paid the rent. The rent was, and we're recording it in the red column with the takeaway sign. Okay, not the plus sign. Not the blue, the red takeaway sign. Okay. All right. So we're going to type in 585 dollars. Okay. So now we have to subtract 585 dollars. Okay. From $2,774.69. That's our balance after paying, after getting our paycheck. So subtract, minus sign. Which should leave us with a grand total of $2,189.69. Okay. Okay, well, that's it for today, Cornerstone friends. And next comes the song. Stay tuned. Okay, Cornerstone buds, here's a song, Christmas song. Frosty the Snowman was a jolly, happy soul, with a corncob pipe and a button nose and two eyes made out of coal. Frosty the Snowman is a fairy tale, they say. He was made of snow, but the children know how he came to life one day. There must have been some magic in that old silk hat they found. But when they placed it on his head, he began to dance around. Oh, Frosty the Snowman was alive as he could be. And the children say he could laugh and play just the same as you and me. Frosty the Snowman knew the hudson was hot that day. So he said, let's run and have some fun now before I melt away. Down to the village with a broomstick in his hand. Running here and there, saying around the square, saying catch me if you can. He led them down to the streets of town, red to the traffic cop. And he only paused a moment when he heard him holler, stop. Oh, Frosty the Snowman had to hurry on his way. But he waved goodbye, saying, don't you cry, I'll be back again someday. Thumpity-thump, thump, thumpity-thump, thump, look at Frosty go. Thumpity-thump, thump, thumpity-thump, thump, over the hills of snow, over the hills of snow.